I felt that my senses were leaving me. The sentence, the dread sentence of death, was the last of distinct accentuation which reached my ears. The condemned to death, I knew, perished usually at the auto da fe, and one of these had been held on the very night of the day of my trial. Had I been remanded to my dungeon to await the next sacrifice, which would not take place for many months? I could no longer doubt the doom prepared for me by monkish ingenuity and torture. Then, the mere consciousness of existence without thought, a condition which lasted long, then very suddenly thought and shuddering terror and earnest endeavor to comprehend my true state, then a strong desire to lapse into insensibility. There came thronging upon my recollection a thousand vague rumors of the horrors of Toledo, of the dungeons there had been strange things narrated, fables I had always deemed them, but yet strange and too ghastly to repeat, save in a whisper. Was I left to perish of starvation in the subterranean world of darkness, or what fate, perhaps even more fearful, awaited me? I must have been drugged. A deep sleep fell upon me, a sleep like that of death. How long it lasted, of course, I do not know. Arousing from the most profound of slumbers, we break the gossamer web of some dream. Yet, in a second afterwards, so frail may that web have been, we remember not that we have dreamt. Looking upward, I surveyed the ceiling of my prison. It was some 30 or 40 feet overhead and constructed much as the side walls. In one of its panels, a very singular figure riveted my whole attention. Whispers to the death condemned, even in the dungeons of the Inquisition. The path of the destroying crescent.